Look, this recipe ain't no rough puff, huffle puff, or whatever the f. This is the real deal, and it's only 4 ingredients. Okay, so I'm sure many people are familiar with puff pastry thanks to the mass manufactured frozen kind at the store. Shout out to Big Wheat. But it is so much more than that. To put it briefly, puff pastry is essentially a laminated dough of literally just a very basic lean dough and butter, multiple layers. It's kind of like a croissant, but without the yeast, and it's a lean dough, and it's much more versatile. When I say puff pastry, I'm talking about the kind of stuff that is for a bajillion kinds of tarts. This is the same stuff that's used to make beef Wellington. There are a lot of things that are made with puff pastry. Making your own is wildly different. We're not gonna say brand names, but you should make your own. And the reason why I'm calling out the rough puff method is because it's just not the same. It's just a shortcut. If you're gonna take the venture to make puff pastry, you might as well do it the right way.
All right, so this is a really minimal ingredient kind of thing. So you're gonna start off by combining 1 teaspoon or 7 grams of fine sea salt and 2.5 cups or 320 grams of all-purpose flour. Give that a whiskey maneuver, your words, not mine. Once that's thoroughly incorporated, you're going to stream in 3/4 cup or 177 grams of cold water into that flour mixture, stirring with a fork and breaking it apart and mixing it together. Now it's gonna seem a little dry and clumpy. You can add a little bit extra water, maybe like a tablespoon or so if necessary, but it should be a little bit dry, but still malleable. Knead that a few times just to make sure that everything's thoroughly incorporated and all the flour is hydrated, and you're good to go. You've got a lean dough ready to be rolled out. Now we need to roll this into a perfect 7 by 7 inch or 18 by 18 centimeter dough square. Now the best way to do this is this little trick with wax paper. So take a sheet of wax paper and place your dough in the center of it and fold the wax paper so that the edges make a 7 inch by 7 inch or 18 centimeter by 18 centimeter square, and then simply just roll your dough out to fill in those edges until you have a perfect 7 inch by 7 inch dough square. And just let that bad boy take a nap in the refrigerator. Now's the perfect time to make our butter block. Now this is looking a lot like croissants, huh? Yeah, well, it's not. So you're gonna take 1 cup plus 2 tablespoons or 227 grams of cold unsalted butter, cut into cubes, and you're gonna sprinkle that very lightly with flour just to keep it from sticking all over the place. And then you're gonna gently beat it together using a rolling pin until it comes together to form a solid mass, folding it over itself occasionally using either a spatula or a bench scraper. And then you're just gonna keep repeating that process until it folds together without the butter breaking, which means that it's sort of like more malleable now. Then you can place that on a sheet of wax paper and do the exact same thing that you did with the dough, except this one's gonna be 4 by 4 in inches or 10 by 10 in centimeters. Place that in your fridge alongside your dough and let it rest for 30 minutes. Biggest word of advice, keep your butter cold through the entirety of this process. Now, once your dough and butter have chilled, you're gonna take them out of the fridge, lightly dust a work surface with flour, and place down your dough square. Slightly roll out the points of the dough just to elongate them. Then place your butter square in the center of your dough with the butter square at a diagonal so that the points of the butter are opposite of the dough. It's a little wordy, but you know what I mean. Fold the edges of the dough over the butter so that they all meet together to create a nice little package, then gently pinch all those edges together to completely encase the butter in dough, avoiding trapping any air in there. One air bubble could cause a lot of trouble. Let's just say that. Then roll your dough out into a long rectangle measuring 12 inches or 30 centimeters in length and 6 inches or 15 centimeters in width. Then fold the top part of the rectangle a third of the way down and then the bottom third up and over to overlap the top fold, creating a letter shape, you know, like a brochure, essentially. Now this is the first fold. Now we're gonna roll it out into the same shaped rectangle, but this time rotate your dough 90 degrees so that the open ends of the dough are facing the direction that you're rolling. You don't wanna roll in the exact same direction. You actually wanna rotate it and roll those open edges outward. Then roll your dough into the same dimensions of 12 inches long and 6 inches wide and perform the same letter style fold. Now you've completed 2 folds. Now, just as a note, if your dough resists you at any time during this and it won't get any longer, then wrap it back up and let it rest for 15 minutes in the fridge for the gluten to relax. Just trust me, don't force this. Place them back in the fridge wrapped up for 30 minutes. Then once it's rested, pull it out and perform 2 more sets of folds, letting it rest if necessary for a grand total of 4 folds. Now, I'd recommend marking your package just to keep track of all this, otherwise it's gonna get real confusing real quick. Then just repeat this process for 2 more folds, ending with a grand total of 6 folds. You know, allowing it to rest as necessary. You can totally split these folds across 3 days if you wish, That makes it super easy if you do that. Now, once you've done a total of 6 folds, let it rest for 1 hour or up to overnight before rolling your pastry out. Then just use it in any recipe that calls for puff pastry. Roll it out however you want. Roll it out 1/2 inch thick. Roll it out 1/4 inch thick. Hell, roll it out 1/8 inch thick. That's right, whatever floats your boat. Just for the sake of this recipe, I made some turnovers literally just by stuffing these with a little bit of jam, wetting the edges, folding them over, and baking them at 375 Fahrenheit or 190 degrees Celsius until golden and crisp, which was about 25 to 30 minutes. You can also make a really nice tomato tart just by cutting a little rectangle shape, brushing it with a little bit of olive oil, and adding some sliced tomatoes, and that's right, flaky salt, and baking it at the same time and temperature, and that's it. The possibilities are limitless. Jesus, you know, beef Wellington, wink, wink. Okay, so you've got puff pastry. This is great and all, but there's one more thing we've got to cover, and that's B-roll.
All right, guys, and that is it. So puff pastry, it really wasn't that bad, now was it? Now, you see, to me, puff pastry is the heart and soul of so many great things. This just feels like a good one. And I hope you guys feel like that too. And who knows, maybe we'll go over beef Wellington next time. But until then, if you enjoyed this video or you learned something, leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you next week. Why do I keep saying that? You're gonna see me in a few days. Look, I'm not gonna make excuses. I'll see you in the next gosh darn video, okay? Ah, I love you, ah.